Hello there, fellow model makers, and welcome to the fourth part of this beginner's guide to hand painting your first kit. Last time, we painted the kit and gave it a nice gloss varnish. We are now ready to start fixing the decals. I start with the biggest decal, the checkered pattern on the engine cowling. Big decals that wrap around curved surfaces are usually a little tricky to fix. I start by cutting the decal and dipping it in room temperature water. While the decal detaches from the sheet, let's take a look at some decal softening solutions. These are from various manufacturers, but essentially they all do the same thing: melt the decal so that it conforms better to the surface. This is my favorite decal solution, Microsol. If you do not use a decal solution, you will find it hard to get the decals to look like a part of the paint job on the kit. Instead, they will stand out, like stickers. With the decal now loose from the sheet, I can fix it in place. I start by wetting the surface where the decal will go with water. I do this for large decals since it helps in moving them to the correct position. I slide the decal onto the kit and then move it about till it is in the correct position. I then apply the decal solution and let the decal conform. Based on my experience from the first decal, I make additional cuts on the second half to help it conform better around the curved surfaces. I do this before dipping the decal in the water so that it does not tear while cutting. I now fix the second half in place. I roll a Q-tip over it to remove any air or water that may be trapped under. I should have done this for the first decal as well, but I guess I forgot. In hindsight, I should have perhaps chosen an easier decal scheme for the beginner's guide. These ones around curved surfaces are difficult to fix in the best of circumstances. And as it turned out, these were not the best of circumstances. The decals in the kit are ill-fitting and do not conform properly. What is more, this decal is too small and does not even link up all the way around the cowling. While this is not something you should be struggling with as a beginner, it does provide a good opportunity to show you how to get out of tight corners. Since there is no way I can stretch the decal, I just fix it in place best I can and leave it to dry. Walking away from a bad situation is often the best thing to do. I will just take my time and think of a solution for this problem. Fiddling with the decal or getting frustrated will not help, rather it's more likely to make things worse. As it happened, things got a lot worse fast. The stripes on the fuselage tore while I was trying to fix them. When I finally did manage to fix the decal in place, I realized that it was very poorly designed as well and would not conform to the curved surfaces. So, I took my hobby knife and cut slits in the decal to make it sit better. This once again resulted in gaps, but that is something I will have to fix later. I fixed the decal on the other side as well, once again relying on the hobby knife to cut slits for a relatively better fit. Now before we move on, there are two issues I need to fix. First, I need to get the decals to sit properly. I do this by first applying the decal solution multiple times. I then take a hairdryer and warm up the decal. This softens the decal and I can coax it to fit better by applying some more solution and pushing it down with a Q-tip. Be very careful while doing this because you can easily tear the decal. I did this for several hours till I was satisfied with the fit. The second issue that needed fixing were the gaps and tears in the decals. The fix was simple enough. I took my brush and with white paint, I painted in all the places where there were gaps. I also filled the entire gap for the cowling decal with white. Next, I went in with black and painted over the gaps in the black part of the decals. Lastly, I hand painted the checkered pattern over the cowling. The guns were also painted with black. I now applied another coat of gloss varnish to cover the decals and protect them during weathering. It is important to do this as sometimes the weathering washes and paints can go under the decal and ruin them. So it is best that they are sealed properly. Time to paint the canopy. Now usually I use masking tape to mask the canopy. However, when the masking surface is really small, like this canopy, I often use a masking fluid. It is easier to apply and also, unlike tape, the chances of paint leaking under the masking fluid are much less, especially while hand painting. Besides, this was a good opportunity to show you how this fluid works. I simply take a cocktail stick and carefully apply the fluid. The fluid tends to stick to the edges of raised features of the canopy frame, making it easier to apply. And the finish is also very clean. Once the fluid is dry, I simply hand paint the canopy frame. I apply multiple layers of paint to make sure that light doesn't seep through. The canopy is also given a coat of clear varnish so that it matches the rest of the kit. Time now to apply a wash. I will be giving the kit an oil wash. I will use these two colors, black and brown. I dilute the oil paints with some odorless thinner. Then I apply this mixture all over the kit. Once the wash is dry to touch, which took about 20 minutes, I wiped it away with a paper towel. Oil paints take a long time to dry, so make sure you give it time, else you will simply apply and wipe all the wash away. What we want is that some wash stays in the rivets and panel lines, to make them stand out. In narrower places like the wheel wells, I use a Q-tip to wipe the wash. I now spray the kit with matte varnish. This will dull down the paint job and make the kit look more realistic. You can see the difference in finish between the top and the bottom of the kit. Once the varnish on top was dry, I turned the kit around and sprayed matte varnish on the lower side as well. The paint looks a little flat right now, so let's add some tonal variation. I want to show that at some places the paint has faded. I will be using this yellow oil paint for this. This area near the cockpit where there would be more use is one place that we can show some fading. I apply a little oil paint here and then blend it out. The top ridges of the aircraft also get the same fading. This is where the sunlight and rain would be likely to wear the paint down. I use the same technique on the wing roots, only this time I use brown oil paint. This is to mimic dust and grime build up in these areas. For the lower side, I use brown and black paint to add some streaking, particularly around the wheel wells. I also make exhaust streaks using the same two colors. Now, with a fine tip brush and some aluminium paint, I add some chipping. I make sure that the chipping is very fine to keep it in scale, and that I do it in areas where there was likely to be more wear and tear, like around the cockpit and the wing roots. Also, I follow along panel lines, as the edges of the panel are likely to chip more easily than other areas. Right then, fellow model makers, it's done. Here is the finished hand-painted Academy 1/72 scale P47. Please do let me know if you enjoyed this build. To be honest, I was expecting more views on this series since a lot of viewers had requested it. I had initially planned to build more hand-painted kits with increasing level of detailing. But given the less than overwhelming response, I am putting that on hold for a bit now. So please, if you are interested in more such videos, do comment and let me know. If you like the series, do leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you already haven't done so. I guess that wraps it up. Till next time, good luck and happy model making.